So my topic is on salivary signature in forensic profiling. These are the contents. So basically, saliva is secreted from the three major glands, that is parotid, submandibular, and sublingual. And the composition of saliva is basically when CO2 is infused in the gland and with a combination of water, hydrogen carbonate is released, in which hydrogen and sodium ions are released. And in the composition of saliva, there are organic and inorganic substances, in which enzymes are also there in organic substances like amylase, maltase, lipase, lysozyme, and some other organic substances are proteins, blood group antigen, free amino acids, and in inorganic there are sodium, calcium, potassium, bicarbonate, bromide, chlorine, and oxygen, carbon dioxide, and nitrogen. So how do we collect saliva? First is stimulated expectoration every 30 seconds, as in we have to spit it, and by gustatory acids, as in the stimulation of the saliva, and mechanical chewing by chewing of paraffin, wax, rubberband, or chewing gums. Unstimulated saliva is in draining method, spitting, suction, swab method. How is it better? It is better because it is in non-invasive, easy, and cost effective. Saliva does not clot. Population-based screening, risk stratification, prognosis. Recent advances in salivary biomarkers for diagnosis of many diseases. Salivary concentration better represents circulating levels of free hormones. So how the DNA is extracted from saliva? First, the saliva sample is taken, then lysis. Lysis is the basically breakdown of saliva, and binding buffer is induced in this by cMAC DNA particles in buffer. They extract the DNA. Basically, they act like a magnet. So that is why cMAC is introduced in the salivary solution. And after that, the DNA is DNA is extracted from the saliva. Material and method. A literature search was performed on electronic databases, PubMed, Scholar, and other keywords with salivary microbiome forensics in May 2018, which revealed three articles from PubMed and 789 results from Google Scholar. Relevant articles from databases and references tracking were shortlisted on the basis of inclusion criteria pertaining the role of saliva in reconstructive forensic identification. So basically, why salivary signature? Any traces that of saliva left behind in bite marks or lip prints, which gives information about age, gender, personal identification, health status of the individual, is used to create salivary signature. Shown diagrammatically following are the details of component of salivary signature. So what happens why do we need salivary signature in case of any crime? So for one, there is comparative identification. This is when we know a suspect. If we know a suspect, we can take the saliva, we can take extract DNA from it, and we can compare the suspect. If there are two suspects, we can compare in from them. And if we don't know any identification or anything in salivary signature, we can get personal characteristics, health status, age, and gender. In personal characteristics, salivary microbiome, genolocation is there, health status, salivary biomarker is there. If there are any health issues in the human, like oral disease or any type of cancer or any inflammatory disease, can be extracted from the salivary DNA. Age by methylation, gender by hormones, that can be get the information from the saliva, like testosterone or anything. Salivary microbiome. So in saliva, in dental biofilm, there are many bacteria. So salivary microbiomes like Mogi bacterium, Streptococcus, Gamma P. provetella, Campylobacter are the main salivary microbiome that exist in the saliva and as well as in dental film, biofilm. So how the analysis of the salivary microbiome is done? First, the collection of the sample is taken. Then the directed or undirected sequencing is done by taxonomic distribution. Taxonomic distribution is the family in which we get the species of the, like if we have species, genus, family, and there are the many taxonomes then where we can distribute them. Then analysis of the DNA or RNA is done in the salivary microbiome, and the identification is done on the basis of forensics. So what actually in forensics, it's done sample collection, that is saliva, DNA extraction, taxonomic classification in which species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom, or domain we identify. Refraction, library preparation, amplification, then statistical data analysis, taxonomic profiling, and differential analysis is done in which alpha diversity and beta diversity is gained. So time of collection, bacterial taxonomic data vary with different time points, hence may be linked with to time of death based or postmortem interval estimation. However, more than salivary microbe signature, gut, bones, and skin are majorly researched during the decomposition. Personal identity, on the basis of fingerprints in saliva, of the victim, the sexual assault case may link to the suspect to the crime. The microbial DNA also relate to the categorically to the ancestral genomic background, identifying the ethnicity of the suspect. Literature holds the prospect of the fingerprint bacteria, especially Streptococcus salivaris or of viridin group, present in saliva in association with the suspect's saliva collected from the bite mark. Variation of age. So basically, before 6 hours, there is a sterile environment of during the birth. After 6 hours, 6 hours of birth, the bacterial colonization begins. The early colonization is marked with the presence of Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, Enterococcus, Micrococcus, and Velenula. This slowly transforms into S. salivaris in infants found in the tongue. Diverse Streptococci species and Actinomyces dominate the bacterial flora with the interruption of teeth and formation of dental plaque. The flora becomes comparable to adult from the age of 5 years with the absence of spirochetes and P. vetula, Prevotella melanogenic as exception. However, loss of teeth can cause marked decrease spirochetes, Streptococcus sanguinis, lactobacillus. Age by methylation of DNA from saliva can yield the age of the person within the 5 years of 5 years approximately. Persistence. So basically, our human DNA is a eukaryotic cells, and prokaryotic cells are the bacterial DNA. So more the eukaryotic DNA, eukaryotic cells DNA, that is linear DNA, can be destroyed easily rather than prokaryotic DNA that is protected by a cell wall and not easily destroyed. Salivary biomarkers. There are many salivary biomarkers, just like prostaglandins, interleukin 6, alpha, beta, TNF, MMPs. These are the inflammatory biomarkers that can give us the details about any disease in the human body, like Sjögren syndrome or any leukemia or any deficiency of the vitamins or any deficiency in the body, like anemia. This can be given by the salivary biomarkers. Gender. Unstimulated whole saliva flow rates as well as the salivary constituent of testosterone, etc., are different in males and females. NA from saliva can yield the age of the person within 5 years approximately. Potential scope of salivary signature in forensic dentistry. Forensic dentistry is inevitable, uses teeth for reconstructive profiling of individual by age and gender assessment. This can be further strengthened by analysis of oral fluids like saliva for its constituent, and hence salivary signature to ascertain the complete biological profile of the individual. The forensic dentist can prove instrumental in initiating the oral microbial data banks, which are geographical location and population specific. Further, multiple systemic and oral condition can be explored for specific salivary genomics or biomarkers, which invariably hold the great research potential in forensic dentistry. Conclusion. Salivary signature can be useful in forensics once the technique of collection and storage of saliva are made more robust. In the branch of dentistry, a periodontist plays an immense role in collection of oral microbiota as salivary biomarker, which can add in data banks depending on their geographical location and demographics, and therefore it can provide a scope of comparative geological and personal identification. These are my references. Thank you.